When it comes to humanitarian aid for Africa, traditionally it's meant taxpayer-funded programs like PEPFAR or privately funded shipments of medical supplies, food, and other goods. A nonprofit organization called GiveDirectly is pioneering another approach in Eastern Africa, giving cash unconditionally to the needy. The latest project involves providing what's called a universal basic income, whereby every adult in a designated area receives a regular cash payment. In tonight's signature segment, NewsHour Weekend Special Correspondent Christopher Livesay reports from Kenya.
Maglene Owino Ndiwa lives in a rural village in western Kenya called Kalawande South. As a subsistence farmer, she and her husband struggle to support their five children.
Most of the money that we get is always spent on school fees, because if we don't pay the fees, they are sent home.
For years, she's made tough decisions on whether to pay those fees, buy food, or improve her tiny, mud-thatched home with its leaky tin roof. Then, last year, a U.S.-based nonprofit organization called GiveDirectly came to her village and offered her $1,000 in cash, 10 times her annual earnings, and said she could spend it on whatever she wanted. 70% of the 281 families in this village received cash from GiveDirectly, which targets people living on less than $1 a day. Ndiwa used her cash to build this bigger house.
How has life changed now that you've gotten this cash?
It's not easy to live with five children in a small house, but now I have a good home that's not leaking and has enough space to accommodate all the children. I am happy.
The big idea was giving people money to make them less poor. It almost seems so obvious.
Economist Michael Fay was one of four graduate students studying development economics who co-founded GiveDirectly in 2009. Unlike other aid groups that provide goods or services, nearly 90% of its donations go straight to recipients as cash.
We were frustrated with many of the same things that a lot of donors are frustrated with. Nonprofits are opaque. The money has to pass through multiple hands, and only a fraction of it winds up in the hands of the poor.
Funded by private donors and foundations, including several based in Silicon Valley, GiveDirectly has distributed nearly $56 million across western Kenya and Uganda since 2011, providing up to $1,000 to 65,000 families with no strings attached.
You fix a window there?
You're going to put a window on the side?
Yes.
People use GiveDirectly's cash in a wide variety of ways. Sylvanus Olweni Aluo used the money to buy food, clothes, and livestock, and build this modest new house. Daniel Amondi Odipo used part of his GiveDirectly grant to pay his wife's dowry. And many recipients use the money to start a business.
Chicken broth, some candy, I see toothpaste.
Jane Akech Orege opened this small general store and a barber shop next door.
So there's nothing keeping a recipient of this money from doing something with it that the donor doesn't like.
That's right. There's obviously things that a lot of us would agree are bad, smoking, alcohol, and so on. But there are other things that we as donors think about. Maybe we think someone should spend it on education. Maybe we think they should spend it on a cow. And I think there's a degree of self-reflection that we should have on why we have those preferences and why we think those preferences are more important than the poorest preferences.
GiveDirectly's cash is distributed through M-Pesa, a widely used mobile money system that allows Kenyans to receive and send money for a small fee. If a potential cash recipient doesn't own a cell phone, GiveDirectly provides one. The money is given in three lump sum payments, and as part of enrolling in the program, every recipient is vetted in person. Diana Acheng Mwaga is a GiveDirectly field officer. While leaving decisions up to the recipients, Mwaga documents how they plan to spend the cash and collects data on their lives before they receive the money. GiveDirectly relies on outside researchers to assess the impact of their cash transfer program. One study published last year on GiveDirectly's work found recipients increased livestock ownership by 50%, reported a significant decrease in depression, and didn't spend more on alcohol and tobacco.
Cash transfers are not only the future, they're the present.
World Bank economist Burke Osler says research across the globe shows the advantages of cash as a form of aid, especially in the short term.
I think we have more and more evidence that suggests that unless you have a very good reason to give people something else, you should give them cash instead.
While certain benefits of cash have been widely studied, GiveDirectly still has to convince the people it's trying to help, many of whom are skeptical.
What is the religion behind this thing?
Field officer Diana Acheng Mwaga has had to knock down rumors of ties to sinister religious forces. Magleen Ndiwa says, unlike her, some people in her village refused the money.
They were saying so many things, that we will be forced to give up our children, that we will die.
Maria Koth is co-wives with Ndiwa, married to the same man, a common practice in this part of Kenya.
When you first heard about GiveDirectly, what did you think?
I was not happy because money that you have not worked for, you cannot be comfortable taking it.
The Kenyan government also runs cash grant programs for more than 700,000 households with vulnerable children, the elderly, and the disabled, providing monthly stipends of about $20. Gladys Wanga is a member of Kenya's parliament.
Are you learning anything from GiveDirectly?
Yes, I think one of the lessons that the government programs can learn from GiveDirectly is transparency and just a level playing field for everyone and just a tool that vets, and if you meet the criteria, you're good to go.
Wanga represents Homa Bay, an area in western Kenya where GiveDirectly has given out cash since 2015.
Have they followed through on what they claimed they were able to achieve?
Yes, they've certainly followed through. Lives have changed. They promise what they do. They don't promise what they can't do.
GiveDirectly has been making lump sum payments to the poorest individuals in Kenya for years. But what would happen if entire villages were recipients? That's what GiveDirectly wants to find out, with an experiment stretching 12 years.
The idea is to provide what's known as a universal basic income, universally providing every adult in a village enough cash to cover the basic cost of living. The concept of a universal basic income has been debated in both poor and rich countries around the world. In wealthier economies, it's been proposed as a replacement for safety net programs, a way to combat growing income inequality, and even to address job losses expected from automation. Other countries are already experimenting with the idea. In Finland, the government has begun a universal basic income trial for some of its citizens. And governments in Canada, Scotland, and the Netherlands have also proposed trials. And in the United States, a private organization has proposed a trial in Oakland, California. GiveDirectly's $30 million program in Kenya will be the largest and longest experiment of its kind. Recipients will receive about $22 a month, which is close to 75 cents a day. Last October, it started providing a basic income in this village to test the model. Kennedy Oswan Abagi is the village's elected elder.
12 years is a long time. Hopefully by that time, everybody shall have invested in something that can support their families, like rearing livestock or farming crops, so that their lives can continue smoothly.
His village is one of 300 that will be part of the universal basic income experiment. The villages will be randomly divided into four groups. Some will get lump sum transfers. Some will get money for 12 years. Some for 2 years. And other villages will get nothing, acting as controls to see the impact of the basic income.
How much income does she normally make in a month?
Princeton University economist Alan Kruger is one of the independent researchers that will analyze data from the basic income experiment. He was visiting the pilot village along with GiveDirectly co-founder Michael Fay.
So this is the questionnaire that recipients go through.
That's right.
It's pretty weighty. How long does it take to actually get through all these questions?
At the moment, it's taking just under 3 hours, and we're trying to cut it down.
Participants will be asked about everything from their hopes for the future to their incomes.
You don't just focus on a single outcome. You have to look at a range of outcomes.
How did you react the first time you heard about it?
Although worlds apart, Faye believes lessons from the universal basic income experiment in Kenya will be relevant to Europe and the U.S.
That might seem like apples and oranges to a lot of people. Kenya compared to the U.S.
It is absolutely apples and oranges, and you could also say Detroit and Oakland are also apples and oranges. And as an economist, this is why you do the experiment many times, to learn what is universal and what is locally specific, but you certainly need to pick somewhere to start.
I think there are aspects to economic behavior that cut across cultures, but we'll see how much we can extrapolate from the fields here in Kenya to other contexts.
World Bank economist Burke Osler has doubts about how much researchers will learn from the basic income experiment in both rich and poor countries.
If we're talking about the US or Finland or Switzerland or something like that, the context and the amounts will be so different. And then on the developing country side, I'm worried that the amount's too large.
Osler fears that a country like Kenya could never afford to implement a program like GiveDirectly's for all of its citizens. He would also like to see the experiment go further and test for GiveDirectly's cash payments against other types of charitable aid in rural Africa, such as vaccines, mosquito nets to prevent malaria, or free livestock.
I'm not going to convince you that cash transfers are better. You're not going to convince me that giving people chickens is better. So let's just put it to the test.
How do you measure success in a program like this?
It's almost hard at some basic level for it not to be successful, simply because you're giving people that are living on 50, 60 cents a day money that will take them above the poverty line. I think broader success is shifting the sector to a place that is based around evidence, that is transparent and honest, and puts the recipient at the center of aid programs and not just the donor.
Aid recipient Kennedy Oswanabagi says he plans to use his cash gifts to expand his carpentry business and invest in more livestock. And he's thinking long term.
Our only hope is that GiveDirectly will fulfill its promise of continuing to send us the money for 12 years without interruption so that we can continue investing in projects that will sustain us afterwards.